James chapter 2, verses 14 to 18.
Faith,
if it does not have works, is dead. What good is it, my brothers, if someone says he has faith but does not have works? Can that faith save him? If a brother or sister has nothing to wear and has no food for the day, and one of you says to them, go in peace, keep warm, and eat well, but you do not give them the necessities of the body, what good is it? So also faith of itself, if it does not have works, is dead. Indeed, someone might say, you have faith and I have works. Demonstrate your faith to me without works, and I will demonstrate my faith to you from my works.
Can we be saved by faith alone?
No.
The concept of being saved by faith alone began with Martin Luther in 1517. It was condemned by the Council of Trent because it clearly contradicted Scripture. Luther's open letter on translating was written in 1530. In his letter, Luther attempts to defend his having added the word alone to Romans 3, verse 28. His defense is primarily his claim that faith alone was clearly what St. Paul intended to say. So Luther says his translation simply clarifies St. Paul's thinking. It's important to note that Luther claims that he knew exactly what St. Paul's intention was. During the preceding 1500 years, no one else had even attempted to claim he knew what St. Paul wanted to say, and thus give themselves permission to change his words. Only Luther did that. In this, as in other matters of doctrine, Luther would accept no authority except his own. In his letter on translating, he told his followers how to respond to Catholics who criticized him for adding the word alone. Tell them, he said, Dr. Martin Luther will have it so, and he says that a papist and a donkey are the same thing. Again, he instructed his fellow believers to say to his critics, Luther will have it so, and he says that he is a doctor, that is, theologian, above all doctors of the Pope. He was very adept at vilifying his Catholic critics. In attempting to justify Luther's editorial handiwork, Lutheran apologists listed several writers before Luther's time who also inserted the word alone as he did. But of course, the errors of others could not justify Luther's error. You may recall that Luther denied the Epistle of James as inspired scripture. His reason, James 2:17, declares that faith without works is dead. Read his own remarks about this biblical book in his preface to the Epistle of St. James and St. Jude, where he rejects the book's apostolic authority and declares, I will not have it, this epistle, in my Bible, to be numbered among the true chief books. Apparently, Luther would have liked to remove this epistle of straw, as he termed it, from the canon altogether, but he did not quite dare. Again, in St. James chapter 2, verse 26, he reaffirms what he said in 2:17. Faith, apart from works, is dead. Luther's concept of faith was that all man's sins have been forgiven by God when Christ died on the cross. If that were so, why did St. Peter and others call for continuing the need to turn away from sin and repent? Think of it this way. If all your sins had been forgiven when Christ was on the cross, then why can't you live any way you want without fear of hell or eternal damnation? The Bible clearly says that hell exists, but if all your sins are forgiven, how then could anyone go to hell? Faith implies the acceptance of all of God's revelation found in God's Word, and eternal damnation is in the Bible. Faith necessarily leads to doing good. Jesus modeled his faith and good works his entire life on earth.